I'm here with Kelly Dobbins of Mid-South Drug Testing. Hey, Kelly, thanks for having us.
Hey, thanks. It's great to be with you.
So you do a lot of work with law enforcement, and we never really see what happens after, you know, a breath alcohol test leaves, you know, like a squad car. So we're getting somebody drunk. So we have our trusty subject here, who happens to be your daughter.
Hi, Madison.
Hi, Madison.
Hi.
So yes, we also have a small bottle of vodka. And so you're just prepping the machine here?
I am. I'm just, it asks a few questions. It wants to know what your ID number is. It wants to make sure the date and the time are correct. It's looking for alcohol in the breath, which equates to alcohol in the blood. Mm-hmm. There's an equation that it goes through, and it's all the components inside know what that is. And then it wants you to insert a mouthpiece.
Ready?
Yeah. There you go.
That's not really.
The way this works is that is because she just put it in her mouth, mm-hmm. actually, it will make the device go into a positive. But it'll be gone in 15 minutes. Screening. Keep blowing, keep blowing, keep blowing, keep blowing. There you go.
Okay.
Now that's thinking right now. That's the little squiggle line. It's thinking back and forth and back and forth and back and forth. And you see it's taken a little while to read it.
Mm-hmm.
Well, as a collector, that's our cue that they've probably had something to drink.
Oh, wow. Point and toe.
0.282. So let's say our legal limit is 0.08. Mm-hmm. So 0.282 would be very drunk.
Very. What's happening there before we...
It's printing three different pieces of the receipt because an alcohol testing form is a three-part form.
Really?
And now it's going to go into a confirmation. So it's a 15-minute wait. And the reason for that is because it is possible to use mouthwash or have a mint in your mouth or something like that and to trigger a positive on the device. After 15 minutes when she does this again, it should come back negative because that's not actually in her body. That's just a little bit in her mouth.
So let's talk about some of the other tests that you do. What are the top three tests that you get asked to do?
Well, in Memphis, it's pretty much marijuana and cocaine. Methamphetamine crosses back and forth. Arkansas, we see a lot of methamphetamine and hydrocodone.
And who's requesting this?
It's employers, court-ordered, students that have to go possibly to trucking school or nursing school. They have to be drug-tested pharmacy techs. So we see a lot of students and a lot of employers do too.
What is one of the craziest stories or the craziest numbers you've seen and or both?
In alcohol, we actually had a positive that was right below 4.0.
Oh my word, I've never even heard of that.
These don't go over 4.0 because literally you should never be able to blow that high and be standing up.
Right.
Normally, you're not going to see something over, usually over 0.2. You're not going to see a whole lot of that because 0.08 is your legal limit. And so even if you were double that, it'd be 0.16.
Mm-hmm. What do you think employers need to know about drug testing, about what you do?
Really, as drug testing is changing, it's been changing, but it's changing very quickly right now. With a lot of the marijuana laws and things that are being decriminalized and and legalized, a lot of people are saying, well, we want to get away from testing for marijuana. Well, you don't have to actually quit testing for marijuana. You can change what type of test you're doing. So you've got a urine test and a hair test and an oral fluid test, which is a swab.
Okay.
And so this test that's recently been approved by the Department of Transportation for your truck drivers and your airline pilots,
okay.
It's only going to get marijuana for about a day or less. So people that are concerned that they might have a population of people that are smoking marijuana and they don't want to deal with the legalities of it could actually switch from a urine test to an oral fluid test.
And you told me, I know we have a little mannequin here, that's, you know, what do you have that there for?
Well,
tell.
This is a hair test. We're going to go through how we go about doing a hair test so you'll understand. We have to use about 200 hairs when we do a hair test. And a hair test is going to go back about 90 days. So every half inch of hair goes back, every half inch of hair goes back 30 days. So when you're looking at this, you take it from as close to the scalp as you can.
Wow.
And the lab's only going to test an inch and a half.
The closest to the scalp.
The closest to the scalp.
Okay, so basically down here it's gone.
Right. And really you don't want to go past a year. In theory, you probably could go up to maybe 5 years, but you probably wouldn't want to go past a year because it would get too muddy.
How long do drugs stay in the system? Like when you look at the range of drugs?
In urine, they stay in the system 2 to 3 days, except for marijuana, which is 2 to 6 weeks. Oral fluid, they stay in your system a couple of days. And hair, a typical hair test is 90 days, so you'd get a 90-day window, but you could go up to a year.
Story you told me just moments ago was about somebody coming in with a wig trying to test their wig.
He did not want us to test his actual hair, so he was at our front window trying to stick his head through the window, and when we got back here we realized he had a wig on.
Oh my gosh.
And it was a really bad wig too. It wasn't even a good wig, but he thought he'd get away with us testing wig hair. The sad thing is a lot of the wigs are made from human hair, so you don't know. You could have had someone else's drug deposits in the wig hair.
And what happens after, you know, there's a positive drug test? Like, you know, the employers pretty much turn down that.
Well, they make the decision.
Yeah.
We just report.
Okay.
So if they want to keep them and they know they're positive, they can put them on a program.
Okay.
Or they can fire them and move on. So it just really depends on what the employer wants to do.
All right, Kelly Dobbins, thank you so much from Mid-South Drug Testing.